Good morning, everyone. For breakfast, Honesty's having some eggs, kind of in between scrambled and omelet, and some water, and she's going to have half a banana, and K-I-W-I. Apparently, I can't spell this morning. As you can tell, I sound like crap. I had no motivation to get up this morning. Not feeling well, I have low energy. And Matt really didn't want to stay home and help out, I guess. When he could have. Because he has days with pay that he could have taken. I mean, I've got this kitchen to clean. I've got to watch her, play with her. I don't know where that energy is going to come from, but it's going to come from somewhere. She woke up around 8:30, and then by the time I got her, it was like 9:10 or something like that. And she's been whining and crying and screaming and stuff, so. Anyway, I gotta go get her banana and kiwi because she's all done her egg. So I got the kitchen clean and the dishes are in the dishwasher. The only thing that's left are those, and I don't feel like washing them, so they're gonna have to go in the next load. Half the time I've been trying to clean up, Honesty's been bawling and he was yowling for food. And now I'm making a ginger tea because I need to relax. I'm going to put some honey in it. And I guess we'll go watch some cartoons because she clearly doesn't want to play. And anyway, the psychiatrist's office called today, the new referral, and they had a cancellation, so they got me in. Which is great. So, hopefully things can start to get better from here. Now we're playing with her carton of eggs while my tea is steeping, and then we're gonna go watch some cartoons. For lunch, Honesty's having some steamed white rice with tuna and some spices, ketchup, mayo, and some veggies there, and some tofu, because I felt like there wasn't that much tuna in comparison to the other stuff, so just in case. And then I made a sandwich with the rice and tuna, and she's having water to drink, and I'm having water with cranberry juice and lemon juice, warm water. And for dessert, she'll have a half a banana and some strawberries mashed up. Yummy. Oh, you gotta turn your spoon around. So, Matt's gonna be here in a little bit, and I have to go get blood work done. And then we're going to that psychiatrist appointment. Oof, I'm really itchy from showering. I just showered. So don't mind me. You're gonna see me scratching all over the place. And anyway, I'm really nervous about the appointment. Mostly because I don't like being misunderstood, and a psychiatrist or psychologist's job is to, is to judge people and put labels on you. And you know, like, I don't want him to make me into something I'm not, or make me, like, it kind of, I don't know, maybe I'm just being paranoid, but makes you wonder if sometimes you go to these psychologists and they make you into something you're not, like, I don't know, maybe I just have depression, anxiety, and some postpartum depression, but, like, what if he wants to label me bipolar disorder, and I don't know, and that's scary, because usually when you have bipolar disorder, they want you medicated, so, and from what I read, he is a pill pusher, from what I understand, maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I need to let go of how I want to be made better and see another way. Anyway, I'm open. I'm just nervous. And I'm hoping for the best.
It's 9:55, and I went to the psychiatrist appointment, and I'd say it went pretty well. With regards to pinpointing issues and such. He's very perceptive, and he definitely got what my issues were and brought Matt in as well after he had the initial talk with me. And I told him, I was like, I'm not afraid to say anything to Matt, and you can say anything you can say to me, to him, and so on and so forth. And so that was pretty productive. Even the psychiatrist said, look, I mean, when your wife is going through this depression, she's at about 25% of her real self. She is not, you know, fully herself. So she's dealing with all these thoughts and all these issues, and here you are placing this other issue with your parents on top of her and forcing her to go past her boundaries when she's clearly not ready. And he's like, if you don't want her yelling at you, you need to hear her out. And if you want him to hear you out, you need to stop yelling. So this medication, I know, right off the bat, that's the only thing that kind of bothered me, was his suggestion to go on medication. But I was like, you know what? He's right. I have been trying to do this myself since I was 19 years old, going on retreats and doing all this other stuff. And it's only temporary. So you know what? I'll give it a shot. There's nothing saying I have to be on either of these meds for life. One of them for a year if it does work somewhat. Whether or not I benefit from it, I still have to stay on it for a while and slowly be weaned off of it. And then the other one, the ones he gave me are Trintellix and Risperidone. Risperidone for like the ADHD, racing thoughts, anger, irritability. That's probably going to be a good thing, but the only thing I told him that kind of scared me, I was like, my grandmother was on that, and yes, she had psychosis and whatever, and it's usually used for psychosis, it's an antipsychotic, but he's like, I don't want you leaving here thinking that I think you're psychotic, that's not it at all, it's just used for these different things. So, we're going to give it a shot. The only thing is that he said it. Neither of these medications would lead to weight gain or loss in sexual libido. Yet, when I talked to the pharmacist, the first thing she said is, you could lose your sexual libido. And I'm like, oh, that's great, because I barely have one as it is. Unless, the way the doctor explained it, he said, it seems like with your depression, your self-esteem is suffering. So he said, you know, this will probably up your self-esteem and you'll feel better. So with more self-esteem, the reason why I usually don't want to have sex is because I just don't feel good about myself. It's kind of perfect timing though, because she said the only way you'll usually gain weight is if you eat everything in the house, like a bunch of junk food. She's like, but I guarantee you that if you don't have that stuff, the pharmacist said, if you don't have that stuff in your house and you don't go out and get it or whatever, and you just stick to what you have, like apples and whatever. Well, we're going to be doing the potato cleanse soon, so that's why I say it's like perfect timing, because I'm not going to be eating any crap. So this is great. Like you said, it's only going to be up from here. And I mean, don't get me wrong, Matt has tried to help me in his own way. But he's been focusing too much on who's right and who's wrong rather than I need to be there for my daughter and my wife. So just because his mom and dad aren't wrong in wanting to spend time with Matthew and honesty and potentially me, I doubt it. It isn't right for them to step over me needing that time to just relax and be able to recuperate. I need at least 2 weeks. And it's not because I don't like them, but it's because of the energy and the vibe and the feeling I get and the things they say to me and the things they say about other people. I can't handle it. So I need to be able to step back. I start those medications tomorrow. I am getting some junk food. I say that all the time. Oh my God, my throat sounds like shit. But I'm getting it out of my system because I know we're basically just going to eat what we have in the house. But, like, I got a chocolate chill and 3 donuts. I know. A caramel one, a Boston cream, and a vanilla dip or whatever it's called. And then I had McDonald's for supper. Honesty, got taken care of by my aunt and grandmother. Matt went and got them before we went to go get my blood work done. So that's done. Yay. And then I got this random call to go in to see the psychiatrist. And it's because my doctor took me seriously this time. He actually wrote on the referral that he was concerned about me and that things needed to be fixed. So this guy was really good. I liked his upbeat attitude. He's funny. And it's nice. I think I can deal with it. I was still nervous. I mean, my anxiety was acting up even when I was in the secretary's room, filling out my information, my postal code. I gave it to her wrong, and I swore it was right. And then I asked Matt, I was like, what's her postal code? And he's like, blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, what? Really? Really? Wow, why don't I remember that anymore? So, like, this depression is affecting my memory. It's affecting my concentration. It's affecting everything. My sleep. The only thing is, I think he got the wrong impression that I can't sleep. I choose not to sleep because I need time to unwind from my day. It's not that my thoughts race and I can't sleep. I want to deal with my thoughts so I stay awake. Anyway, the risperidone is supposed to calm those thoughts. The way he said it kind of puts those thoughts in the corner, which sucks because, you know me, I like dealing with stuff, but clearly at this time I just don't have the tools to deal with what I need to deal with. So I go to see him in a few weeks. Oh, today I was chewing gum at the blood clinic. And didn't I chip more of a tooth? I'm like, why is it that? Seems like when I was working out and going to the gym, I would I chipped my tooth, one of them that I already got pulled, and I was like, it was just crumbling. Like, it was just weird. Like, I don't know if gum does something to my enamel or my teeth, but geez. I love gum. I love chewing it. It's addictive. Matt and I are going to watch some Parenthood. We finished up the last season of Full House, and Fuller House is on in like 4 days. It's so exciting. I can't wait. Yeah, we're going to watch Parenthood, the last season that's up, season 6. and because we watched all the other five. And I'm super excited because we love that show. So anyway, I am going to go eat a donut and drink a chocolate chill. And I'm going to close up the vlog for tonight. Good night, everyone.